My name is Rucha. It's spelled H-R-U-C-H-A. The H is silent. I feel like I always have to say this to everyone I meet, so I'm gonna tell you too. I am a final year student, incoming final year student at National University of Singapore, NUS. I'm studying life science as well as a second major in psychology. Before anyone asks me, I just wanted to put that out there. So this is a vlogging series I've come up with. It's titled First and Foremost, and why that is the case you'll see in my vlogs as you watch this video and other videos as well. This is most likely to be a 5-part series with volume 1 coming up now. Please enjoy. However, I would just like to explain why I decided to start vlogging. So for some of you that do know me, my close friends as well as my family, they know that I like to go on Instagram stories and like post stories of just random content from my daily life. I like sharing my life. I'm very outgoing, outspoken in that way. So I've always wanted to take that to the next level by vlogging, but I've always been very scared to video edit. So I've done my best this volume. I will have an end card later on explaining that. So stay tuned. This summer, after my semester was over, I did not get any internships, so had no idea how to spend my summer. And I thought that a good way to do it would be to travel. And so I traveled solo on my own to British Columbia for about approximately 21 days. I went to Vancouver as well as Victoria alone. I stayed with a family. You will see that. So I am all packed up and ready to go. It is 6:15 a.m. I should have left my house by now, but of course I haven't. I have eaten a bit of breakfast. This trip is my first long-haul flight. This is my first time flying solo. This is my first time going somewhere out of Asia. Basically a lot first. Yeah, I should have probably mentioned that earlier. Whatever. I haven't slept at all. And so I'm gonna go and see you at Changi Airport. Since the flight was full, check-in took really long. Like, I was at the back of the line and I had reached there at 7. My flight was at 9. So I was like, okay, 2 hours, you know, we'll be done check-in. Like, done checking in my 2 bags. By like half an hour. That did not happen. It took me almost an hour, or maybe even slightly more than an hour. So by the time I got inside after checking in my bags, it was time for me to work. I could not buy breakfast, I could not eat something before I got on the plane.
I'm here, you guys. So, whenever I see people here with luggage bags, I'm very happy for them. And today it's time to be happy for me, because I'm traveling too. Cute luggage bag.
This is where I used to take the train or walk from Jewel. And my gate is over there, B7.
My first flight was from Singapore to San Francisco, 14 hour 50 minutes. It turned to 14 hour 37 minutes because, don't ask me, I don't know.
I'm in the flight, I'm sitting at my seat, I have a window seat.
So, I sat at the window seat and the flight arrangement is 3-3-3. And I was over here on the right half of the plane at the window. And there's two people sitting next to me. A couple, I assume, husband and wife. They didn't talk to me at all throughout the flight. I tried to make conversation, they did not. But the flight was almost full, which is a surprise to me. I thought, okay, you know, the descending COVID world, maybe there might be like spaces between seats. So like mine was 3, right? So I thought it would be 1 space and then 2 like that. But no, it was full. Like, full. I could not get through the rows on my own without having to, you know, push past people, that little dance that you have to do.
ocean, of course, maritime waves, ocean currents, ocean winds, geography, get in it. There was a lot of turbulence, and we were like, oh, please fasten your seatbelts. This announcement came like every 20 minutes, every 25 minutes. So every time I wanted to sense that turbulence, actually did rock me to sleep. Like whenever the flight moved like this, I was like, okay, it's time to go to sleep. There was a period of time, a solid maybe 7 hours, where they had a lights off period. So after they gave us our first meal, which was breakfast, they switched off the lights. Like it was just not pitch black, but like just very dark, so that you can unwind and sleep. My ass couldn't sleep. And I was like, okay, should I watch something on the TV? And then turns out the TV is too bright, and my astigmatism ass is not used to that at all. And another thing was, because my flight was so early in the morning, I was like finishing up charging my laptop in the morning, so I didn't really pay attention to other things that I could do on my laptop, such as download shows or things to watch on my laptop. So I had to rely on like the United, that seat behind TV window screen thing. And the selection was very limited. I was just here like, okay, I don't have much to watch. So I just watched some Hindi movie, and I watched another show called Love, Simon.
So I'm in the toilet. It feels so pricey to tell people to get up so that I can go to the toilet, but here we are, I guess.
It's clearly a very American airline, because with my food, normally like in flight food, desserts or like sweet things, you get like yogurt or, you know, something kind of healthy, something full of sustenance to help you last through your flight. They gave me Oreos and a muffin and Kit Kats. I'm like, okay, this is very American.
If I were to estimate like a total amount of time I slept throughout that 15 hours, almost 15 hours, six? I don't know. Like, this is not continuous, of course, because they kept waking us up for light snacks, for meals. But yeah, 6 hours is a good estimate in total.
I just want to say it's like less than 7 hours to San Francisco. And I'm so overly. Like, I'm just here like, okay, the ocean. How long? Pacific Ocean goes on the smaller.
But at the 8 hour mark, I'm like, can I just get off? Can you just like parachute me down to wherever it is? I'll find my way. I just need to rest and I cannot be on the plane. At the 8 hour mark, I was done because I've already flown more than my maximum. My maximum flight, like the time wise I've ever been on, is 5.5 hours. So at 8 hours, I'm like, okay, I'm already well beyond my limit here. I can just get off now, you know, just now. 6 hours to go, 5 hours to go. From then on, every hour I looked at like the time to destination kind of configuration that they show at the bottom of the screen, because I was like, okay, I'm just counting down the hours as they went on from 8 to 14 hours and beyond. Okay, one thing about me, I don't think y'all know, because we haven't flown, we haven't traveled for so long, is that when landing, my ears die. Like, they get so blocked, they hurt like right about here, and like, let me show you my little ears. They get very painful around here and like right inside about here. So something that I do is that I always have Tic Tacs or some kind of mints on me when I'm flying. Me on the flight, I feel like I've almost inhalated that box. I'll check. I think it's like maybe two more left in there. But I was just eating Tic Tacs on like while taking off, while landing. In the US, because in the US it's not mandatory to wear a mask outdoors, even when you're waiting at the airport, not when you're going through security, but in the airport you don't have to wear a mask. And there were people on the flight, on the next flight that I'll talk about, that were not wearing masks at all, and that was such a culture. talk about my layover at San Francisco Airport, SFO. We got off the plane, walked a little bit through like a little walkway from the arrival gate to US Customs and Border Control. That walkway is fine, you're just walking straight. You reach customs and there's a long ass line, okay, which is to be expected, US Customs. The tragedy for me is that, you know, the trolleys that you get at Singapore Airport, you know, those little fun things you can just put your feet on and ride, just the, that all airports have. In the US, you need to pay money in order to get that.
Morning from the US. I am extremely stressed. It is 9:25. I just got up out of customs and managed to get this damned trolley for $8. I have 3 bags. There's no way I can carry it by myself, all 3 of them. And I have to get to my plane in an hour. My boarding is at 10:25 and it's 9:30. I gotta go. I gotta. Getting a trolley for them was very taxing. I tried with my card, nothing. Tried with money, finally something happened. So now I'm walking to my gate. There was a baggage recheck area that I deposited my 2 check-in bags into. So
I had to pay $8 to get that trolley because I have 2 carry-on, 1 carry-on luggage and 1 backpack. I could have, with my hands, just carried 2 as well as my backpack, but my 3rd luggage would have been left behind. And I didn't know how far my place to check off my luggage again was, because this is my first time coming to the US. Biguk ilchuk anekayo. I will have to excuse myself for that. I totally failed. Okay, anyway, so I dropped my bags off, took my carry-on luggage, went to the checkpoint gate for my gate to go to the next flight. Met a few lovely people there, little ladies who were traveling to New York. One of them was traveling to LA. Spoke to them. It's nice, you know, talking to people just on the airport. It's fun because, I mean, I'm traveling solo, right? So I have no one to speak to other than myself. And I can't look like a crazy person talking to myself in the middle of nowhere on the airport. So I decided to just engage in conversation with people on the next security checkpoint. At the security checkpoint, I was told to take my shoes off and everything, and like we were all complaining and cribbing about it. Felt like a little camaraderie moment, you know? Yeah. And my next flight was actually, I would say, better than my earlier flight. Even though the main like disadvantages of my next flight is that there was no in-flight entertainment, so there's no that TV screen nonsense, none of that. No snacks were provided. I mean, you can get them, but for after you pay, so snacks were purchased. Complimentary beverages, thank God. So second flight, the reason why I would say it was so good, the 2 hours and 41 minutes, it was slightly lesser than that. It passed by so quickly because of my seatmate. If you're watching this, thank you. You are the highlight of my flight. I just started talking to him off the bat because he asked me what the time was and my phone was on, his was off, and I saw him using his phone. I eavesdropped a little bit. He was typing foreign language on the phone. I thought that was like Italian or something. Turns out it was Brazilian. Or I could be completely wrong. Brazilian is probably not even a language. I do not know. Espanol, Spanish. I do not know. I will figure it out. So he was typing on his phone. Then he told me his phone died, so he wanted to know the time. Told him the time, and then we just hit it off. He started telling me about his adventures. He's a frequent flyer, frequent traveler. I'm an infrequent flyer, infrequent traveler, awfully novice series. So he started telling me about his adventures. He's gone to a lot of places around Asia, except Singapore, Malaysia, Indonesia. He's like a mountain climber. So he's gone to Nepal, he got an accident there, stuff like that. So he was just telling me his life story. I was like, okay, please tell me, uncle. It'll help me pass my time. Bultero.
Luckily, the weather looks better here than I was expecting.
It is a thick layer of clouds, so we saw just kind of
stuff. You can see the city or the city center over there now, just straight over there. This is the big university where I studied, the University of British Columbia.
Oh.
It's like a whole peninsula with beaches all around.
Yeah. Oh my god, my eyes are already blessed. I've not seen this much green in years.
not kidding when they said it was cold.
Vancouver airport is definitely way better compared to the US in order to get to places. So after the arrival gate, you just need to walk like 5 minutes to the immigration area. The immigration area, I would say, is similar to Singapore's, where you like take an escalator down, you know, you have that thing, then you go collect your baggage. It's the similar layout, just super similar. But you need to, before you go to immigration, Singapore, there's like nothing that you have to do before that. It's all the counters, right? Over here, you have to show your arrive can, scan your passport, stuff like that. So I had to do that. That was pretty fast, pretty simple. Line slightly long, but it moved along really quickly. Finished my little immigration thing. The immigration officer, very nosy. I see you, girl. See you doing your job really well. I just look like, why are you asking me these questions? I will not share because I don't think I'm supposed to. Though I did share with the people living in the house. And they were like, yeah, it's normal. I'm like, it's normal?
Look at this airport. Oh my god. It's like a rainforest. This is like the Canada version of Jewel. You didn't come to Canada if you haven't had Tim Hortons. I'll hit that one up later.
Came out. Was told that I need to run. I was randomly chosen to take a COVID test. Really? Random? Are you sure? I'm not so sure. Q psychology, pseudo random knowledge.
It's 15 degrees for me is not warm. No. Anything 19 degrees and below, I'm like, okay, it is not warm.
So I live in a house that's my mom's friends and their family stays here, so I'm staying with them. Probably should have told you all this earlier, but here we are. So uncle picked me up. We drove home. Home is about an hour from the airport. But I was so in awe after we came out. But there's just so much more nature. It's so much more lush, so much greenery, so much non-greenery green. Okay, see, plants in Singapore are all one color, green. The occasional red, the occasional yellow, also very tactfully grown. They are supposedly grown in that particular area only. This wasn't the case here. You can see plants of every single color here. You can see tulips, you can see cherry blossoms. And that was my first vlog, people. So you saw me in the start and you're seeing me now here again. This is Future Rucha. I am back from Canada. It's been a few days since I've been back here in Singapore and I've been adjusting to the warm weather. Singapore, step it up, please. So yeah, this was my first vlog getting to Vancouver, volume 1. There's a couple more volumes to come where I'll be traveling around Vancouver and around Victoria as well and showing you my little solo adventures. But I wanted to come on here again to preface two things. One, I do know that the video editing quality on this video is not that great. I'm sorry. This is my first time vlogging, my first time editing. So I tried using a video editing software. No hate to that software. It's just that it wasn't user-friendly to me. So I've switched to a new video editing software from volume 2 onwards. And I really hope I can amp up the video editing quality a little better from volume 2 onwards. That's number one. Number two is that I just wanted to also set the expectations of what these vlogs are going to be like. It's going to be me showing what I see, what I've read about the place, what I've learned from the place, and my experiences, as well as comparing it to Singapore, which I've done many times. Basically, in short, it is British Columbia, aka Vancouver and Victoria, but from my eyes. Okay, that's how it's gonna be like. I just wanted to preface that so you know what you'll be seeing from volume 2 onwards. Yeah, watch this space. New volumes are gonna come out
soon, hopefully. And yeah, stay tuned. See you in the next one.